Today, we are going to be playing a game using one of my favorite things in the whole wide world. Donuts! I love donuts! Do you like donuts? You do? Well, let me show you all the donuts I have. Look how delicious they look! Okay, you see, we've got a white sprinkle and a pink sprinkle. Oh, and my personal favorite, a chocolate donut. They look so delicious. My tummy is starting to grumble. But we're not gonna be eating these donuts just yet. But we are going to do something super duper fun with them. We're gonna be playing a matching game. So there are two of each donut. And we have to flip all these donuts over and then try and find their match. It's gonna be so great. Do you think you can help me? You do? Oh, great! All right, let's get started. So, which one do you think we should pick first? One, two, three, four, five, or six? Let's see. How about number five? Should we pick number five? Okay, let's take a look. It's a chocolate! Oh, it looks so yummy! Okay, so now we have to find the chocolate donut that's somewhere else up here. Let's see. How about number two? Should we do number two? Yeah, let's take a look. Oh, that is not a chocolate donut. No, that's a pink sprinkle donut. But that's okay. That is okay. Let's flip the pink sprinkle back over. And we're still looking for the chocolate. Let's see. How about number four? Let's flip over number four. Oh, we did it! We did it! We found the chocolate donut match! Hey, you did such a great job! This is so fun! Let's keep going! Okay, which one should we flip over next? How about number three? Yeah, should we take a look and see what donut is behind number three? Oh! Well, this is a pink sprinkled. Now, I feel like we've seen the pink sprinkled before. Oh, which number was the pink sprinkled behind? I can't remember. Do you have any guesses? What about number one? Should we flip over number one and let's see? Oh, no. This is the white sprinkled. Okay, we're so close. Let's see. Where could it be? Pink sprinkled donut, where are you? How about number two? Should we take a look? All right, let's see number two. Whoa! We did it! Oh, I wasn't even expecting that! Oh, this is amazing! We found the pink sprinkled match! Okay, I think we have one more donut to find the match for. Let's flip over number six. There it is! There's our white sprinkled donut. But we're looking for one more white sprinkled donut. Where could it be? Did you say number one? You did? Okay, well, I think we should definitely take a look and see if the white sprinkled donut is behind number one. donuts lying around. Can you pick out one of your favorite donuts? Oh yeah, that one looks really tasty. Now can you pretend to eat it? Oh, that was so delicious. I love donuts. Okay, well, you friends are so awesome. I loved hanging out with you all today. And now, it is time for an amazing Bible story just for you. So take a seat and get all comfy and let me see your hands. And open, shut them. Open, shut them. Give a little clap. Open, shut them. Open, shut them. Put them in your lap. It looks like we're all ready.
Hey everybody, my name is Daniel and I am so excited to tell you about something amazing that I read in one of my favorite books. Do you know which book I'm talking about? It's the Bible. And the Bible is so important because it lets us know how much God loves us. So I was reading my Bible and I read something amazing. I read about a time that God helped a man in a very special way. And this man's name was Elijah. Can you say that with me? One, two, three, Elijah. Yeah, way to go, guys. So there was a time in Elijah's life where no rain fell from the sky for a very, very, very long time. So everything was dry and dusty. No fruits or vegetables could grow, and there was no cold, fresh water flowing in the rivers. So Elijah was very hungry and very thirsty. And God saw this, and he knew that Elijah needed help, and God had a plan. So first, God told Elijah to go to a very special place. God told Elijah that there he could find cold, fresh water flowing and that ravens would bring him food with meat and bread so that he could eat. Do you know what a raven is? It's a black bird. And God was going to use ravens to help Elijah so that God could take care of him. So Elijah listened to God and started walking to the special place. And do you want to pretend to be like Elijah and walk to the special place with me? Awesome. So we're going to walk and walk some more, and we're about halfway to the special place that God told Elijah about. And just a little bit more walking, and we made it. We are in the special place that God told Elijah about. And when Elijah made it to the special place, you'll never guess what he found. It's water. It was cold, fresh water that was flowing that Elijah could drink. He wouldn't go thirsty with all the water there. But then it was time for dinner, and you'll never guess what happened. A raven showed up, and hey, he has something in his feet. What is that? It's bread. Do you want to pretend to eat the bread with me just like Elijah did? Awesome. So here we go. Nom, 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 nom. That's so good. And then there's something else. What else is in there? It's meat. Awesome. Do you want to pretend to eat the meat too? Awesome. So here we go. Nom, nom, nom. That's so good, guys. Elijah ate the bread and the meat and drank the water that God had given him. And God had taken care of Elijah. But what about in the morning when it was time for breakfast? Would God take care of Elijah again? Well, let's see. Yes, he would. There was more meat and more bread and more water for Elijah. That is amazing. And just like God took care of Elijah, God will take care of you too. Yes, God takes care of us in many, many ways. Like God gives us sun and rain to help fruits and vegetables grow so that we have things to eat. Oh, on the count of three, can you yell out your favorite thing to eat? Awesome. So one, two, three. Yeah, those are all great things. God takes care of us by giving us things to eat. And then God also takes care of us by giving us mommies and daddies and neighbors and teachers who love us and teach us and take care of us. God will take care of you, and God will take care of me because he loves you. So let's pray and thank God for taking care of us. Can I get a big clap? Awesome. Dear God, Thank you for loving us and for taking care of us. Thank you for the special people in our lives who also take care of us. We love you, God. Amen. That's amazing, guys, and I will be remembering that all week long, that God loves me and that God will take care of me. So until next time, see you later, guys.
I loved listening to it with you. And now it is time for the moment we've all been waiting for. We get to sing and dance to a super duper fun song, and I can't wait. So get up on your feet and put your dancing shoes on, and it's time to dance. Bye, friends.
And it goes.